Welcome everyone. Invite you to join me in a journey in the next few moments for a yin practice that will help to boost your immune system and relax your body-mind. So wherever you are in your space, if you could take the next few moments just to create a space for you for practice, roll out the mat, and if you have a blanket at home, that would be helpful, and a belt or something that might act as a belt, one block, and a bolster or a cushion would be helpful. For modifications during practice. So let's come fully to our spine. Let's just release out. Fully to the spine. And relax your legs out long and the arms out to the side, palms up. Draw the shoulders in on your back and let your heart extend up in a sensation of openness. And let the toes fall away from each other. And we'll begin the journey through our breathing body. So we'll begin by bringing your awareness to your breath. Feeling your spine fully relaxed, sensing the resistance of the earth beneath you, eyes are closed down. With the awareness on the inhale and exhale, begin to notice the quality of your breath. Noticing sensations and fluctuations in and across your body as you take that inhale and exhale. The breathing body is our best measure of how we're feeling in that moment. Notice your own natural rhythm of breath. Sense and feel where you might have any resistance, any pressure, any coolness or heat in the body as you take that inhale and exhale. Keeping the awareness fully on your breath. We're just slowly beginning to fully relax the body. Come into the body fully before practice, before we begin to move the body. We want to ground down and fully come into the space, into the present moment. In the yoga practice, it's called shunya, dropping into that space of deep listening and coming back to the zero point before we begin moving the body and reactivating the thinking mind. So let's begin to deepen the inhalation and lengthen your exhalation. So on that next deep breath, begin to sense and feel your ribcage expand, front and back, sides, expand on that deeper breath. Your belly rises just a little more as you engage the diaphragm. And exhale all the way out, really pushing that breath, every last sip out to create good space for the next inhalation. This is diaphragmatic breathing, three-part breath. The most basic and most potent pranayama in the yoga practice. Deep inhales, fully expand, nurturing and nourishing the capillaries in your lungs, communicating to the whole system, nervous system, endocrine system, the immune system, to relax, relax. When we're in a state of relaxation, it immediately reduces stress. So deeper the breath, longer exhalation communicates also to the fascia to soften and relax. So the nervous system is embedded in the fascia. So the deeper the breath, longer the exhalation, the softer the body, mind becomes. Homeostasis. Deep inhale, long exhale. As you take your next inhalation, let's draw the knees to chest, hug and squeeze. And grab your feet for happy baby. So as you take happy baby, relax your face. Continue to stay with your diaphragmatic breathing. Relax the shoulders towards the mat. Maybe rocking side to side. If your shoulders are a little hiked up or around your neck towards your ears, just consciously release them down towards your mat. If you're not able to reach your feet, then just bring the hands to the backs of the calves, ankles, wherever your body gives you that space to hold. And sustain that deep diaphragmatic breathing. As you take your next exhale, we're going to release the hands and drop the knees to the left. And open your arms like a T, palms to the sky, and that allows the shoulder joint to open just a little more. Stay with your deep breath. And if your neck allows, gaze towards your right shoulder. Once you've landed, once you've arrived, close the eyes down and reconnect to your breath. Energetically, We begin to move the fascia as we hold this posture. So staying in this posture, remaining in this posture. We'll be here for one more minute. Continue with a long, slow, deep breathing and bring your awareness to where you begin to feel the sensation most. So we're doing a very gentle supine twist. And we're asking the side body fascia to soften and open. So energetically, you might move your right hip away from the right shoulder as you take your exhalation. Deep inhales, long exhales. This is a beautiful shape to massage the vital organs in the body, in particular the intestinal tract, the digestive system. Let's take one more deep inhalation, long exhale. Inhale to center, and we're going to sway the other way, just dropping the knees to the right. Opening your arms like a T, palms to the sky, and reconnect to your breath. If your neck feels good to gaze towards your left hand, left shoulder, dropping into the sensation. Sensation in your body, but also what might be coming up for you in the thinking mind. So often when we change shapes and land in a new shape, it invariably engages the thinking mind. So once we land in that shape, and we're in a supine twist right now, staying with our deep breath, we want to reconnect to the inhale and the exhale. So keeping the eyes closed down, staying with your deep breath. On your next inhale, let's bring the left arm up and over to meet your right hand. Rest here on your right side for a couple breaths. When you feel ready, let's make our way up to a simple seated with your right leg in front. You can also sit on a blanket. So sitting on a blanket helps with the pelvic tilt. So if your pelvis is tilting back, if you have just a little curve in the lumbar spine as you're sitting in simple seated, then bring a blanket underneath the sit bones. And that's going to create just a little more space in and around the hip joints and the pelvis for you to lift out of the spine and create a long spine. So as you're seated as a yogi, we always want to have our heart lifted and a long spine. And that creates good space for the lungs and diaphragm to do its job. Let's bring the fingertips out to the side and take a deep breath in. On your exhale, right hand comes to your left knee for a gentle twist. We'll continue to internally massage the spine, massage the vital organs in the body, the digestive system. Close the eyes. Just a gentle gaze inward. And stay with your deep breath. Release and reach to the sky, long spine, and exhale left hand to your right knee. Gentle twist, relax the shoulders, lift out of your heart space, and gaze to the right. Release and reach, deep breath. We'll hinge forward at the hip crease. If you have your block, you can grab your block for the center. Deep breath. Let your heart lead the way. So the first stop would be the pads of the hands. So we want to stop here to check in with the sit bones and ground them down towards the mat. Pull the sacrum down, but we also want to lift out of the heart, so we're engaging two points of energy at the base of the spine and from the heart space, and continue to exhale. Wherever your body says stop, that's where you want to land. Your range of motion might be right here, and that's perfect, or it might be the forearms. If you have the space, you can bring the forehead to the block. There's three heights on this block. You can also stack two blocks on top of each other. So just explore in your body where your body wants to land. Let's rest here for a couple breaths. So as you land, just reconnect to the breathing body. So hold that position. We'll be there for about a minute and a half or 2 minutes. Just going inside and exploring that meditative mind, using the breath, the prana, the inhale and the exhale as your guide. Deep breaths. Let's take a deep inhalation together and walk the hands in. Reach behind you, fingertips away from the body, and take a deep inhale, lift out of the heart, and exhale out the mouth. Roll back onto your sit bones, and switch the cross of your feet, and the left leg will be in front. Fingertips out to the side, so we're going to work the opposite hip. fingertips reach, deep inhale and exhale, left hand to right knee. Lift out of your heart, relax the shoulders, and gentle gaze towards your right shoulder. Release and reach. Long spine. Exhale, right hand to left knee. Gentle twist. Deep breath. Relax the shoulders, the face. Release and reach. Breathe it in. We'll hinge at the hip crease. Let your heart lead the way. Exhale. Come to the pads of the hands. Ground the sacrum, the sit bones to the earth. Lift out of your heart space and release a little further. Only if your body is saying yes. You can rest your forehead on a block if that feels good. And reconnect to the breath. And we'll be here for a minute, minute and a half. Deep inhales, long exhales. Sensing and feeling. Noticing where in your body is the greatest sensation. So here's our opportunity to create a channel. So we bring our awareness to that sensation where we're feeling it most. So most likely in the base of the spine and or in the left, in and around the left hip joint. Depends on your body. So we direct our awareness there, and that creates an immediate channel for your prana to flow. And that's why in the yoga teachings, there's a constant reference to single point of focus, single point of focus. So send that laser-like drishti to where you feel it most. And then your prana will flow there. It's the law of nature. It's one of our most beautiful methods of healing ourselves. Deep breath in. Let's walk the hands in. Reach behind you, fingertips away. Deep breath, lift the heart. Exhale out of the mouth. Roll it back and switch the cross of your feet. Release the block out to the side. Release your blanket. We're gonna rock forward to table. And we're just gonna take a few cat-cow just to massage the spine in a different way and move the prana with a little more heat. So let's inhale and send the heart through the shoulder girdle. Exhale, draw the navel in deep to the spine. And begin to move in a way that feels good for your body. Fluid motions. Motions that match your breath, your inhale, your exhale. Just going as slow as your body is asking for. Stay deep in breath.
Inhale the head up. As you exhale, draw the sit bones towards the heels. Rest your forehead on the mat. Deep breath. Let's inhale halfway and come up on spider fingers, so, or gecko fingers. And do your best to keep your sit bones grounded towards your heels. We're going to walk the hands out to the left. And reach out with the right side body. Rest the forehead down. Deep inhales. Come halfway, let's walk it through center, all the way to the right side, reaching long with the left hand, the left arm, and relax your neck and head. Reconnect to your breath, deep breath. Inhale, halfway. Let's walk it back to center. Come up to table. We're going to walk the knees in and cross the ankles. Let's come back to a simple seated position. And extend the legs out long, right in front of you. And then just begin to pulse the knees up and down, and then side to side. And that just helps to open and loosen the fascia around the hip joints, the knees. And then we're going to move into Janu Sursasana. So we won't typically need a prop for this shape. You'll simply draw the left foot inside the right inner thigh. Ground your right sit bone into the mat, both sit bones actually into the mat. So as we're going to take a forward fold, we want to hinge at the hip crease. As we fold, we want to be mindful that we're not gripping or grasping here in the quadricep, which can put a little stress on the knee joint. So as you arrive into the shape, and off cue as well, begin to notice sensations around the quad and the knee joint. The toes will be flexed towards you, and we'll reach to the sky for a long spine and a deep breath. Hinging forward, let your heart lead the way. So wherever your body says stop, so the pads of the hands might be where you want to land, and that's perfect. Perfect for your body. Keep the knees soft, eyes closed down. Heart stays lifted if this is where your body wants to land. If you have just a little more range, you could come a little further and rest the forehead on a block. And remember that the block has different heights and gives us lots of options. So use that to your benefit in this shape. So once you arrive, we'll be here for 2 minutes. So you're landed here in Janu Sursasana. The eyes are closed and reconnect to your breath. Diaphragmatic breathing, a deep inhale and a long exhale. If you're not able to connect to that deep breath, it simply means you need to come up just a little bit more and
modify. So we, whatever shape that we land in, we want to have a deep belly breath so we can maintain homeostasis. And although we're putting the body in traction and healthy stress, we want to be relaxed in that stress. So we're actually practicing we're practicing on the mat how to manage and respond to life's challenges and stresses. And now, in the time that we're in these moments, it's so important to have your home practice. So stay with that deep breath and continue to bring the awareness to where you're feeling that greatest sensation here in the right hip, in the knee joint possibly, and or in the hamstring. And relax into it. Send that deep breath to where you need it most. Let's take a deep inhale and slowly come up. Bring the block out to the side and extend your left leg long. And pulse. Side to side. And let's draw the right foot in and work the other side. Bring your block in just in case you might need it. And remember that each side is going to be different. So we're always working with contrast in yoga practice, in asana practice, but in life there is contrast. So let's reach to the sky, take a deep breath in, long spine. We're hinging at the hip crease. Relax your left knee. Let your heart lead the way. So remember that the pads of your hands is a great place to land and a beautiful modification. So this may be where your body wants to stop. If it is, stay lifted out of your heart space and connected to your breath. If you have a little more space in the hip joint, your body might want to take it a little further. Allow your head to relax and rest on the block. And then just drop into your deep breath. Reconnect to your breath. Deep inhale, long exhalation. That's going to relax the fascia, invariably the tendon and ligament. So the deeper the breath, the more relaxed your body will be in stress.
Thank you.
And then side to side.
Nice. So we're going to do a forward fold now. And for some, this can be challenging, which is a good thing. You can sit on a blanket, which I recommend, especially if you are feeling tight in the hamstrings or in your back body. So tight hamstrings have a lot to do with the back line of fascia being constricted or tight. So that back line of fascia begins at the crown, goes all the way through the back body, and meets here at the tips of the toe. So it wraps around the whole back body. And it can affect our knees, our hip joints, base of the spine, everything, neck. So I like to recommend doing the forward fold at least 3 times a week or daily if you can. But if you are feeling tight here in the back, please sit on a blanket, and that will give you just a little more space in the hip joints. And if you're sitting on a blanket, so sometimes you might see this, the knees might pop up. You can put a blanket under your knees as well. So sometimes I'll recommend having a blanket under the knees if you're sitting on a blanket, and then maybe a blanket under your knees. So it's really important for the yin practice to use props. They really support our body in the practice, especially if you have a limited range of motion. So we're just gonna, for this forward fold, we're just gonna do a more modified forward fold. So let's say you do have a blanket under your knees as well. The toes will be flexed towards you. We're going to lift out of the heart, and we're going to hinge at the hip crease, just like you did with Jhana Sirsasana. And we always want to be playing with our edge, so we're just being curious about where the body wants to stop and where the resistance is. So curious about the resistance. And that's where we'll find openings and able to send the prana and create some softness. So let's reach for the sky. With breath, create a long spine, and you're going to hinge forward at the hip crease. So maybe your body just wants to stop right here. Bring the pads of the hands to the mat for support. Lift out of the heart space. The sensation would most likely be here at the base of the spine and in the hamstrings. Close the eyes down and just connect to your deep breath. And if you're someone who does have a little more range, who does not need a blanket, just bring the body forward just a little more, and then begin to let the spine round. Another option is to bring a blanket if your spine does, if you do have a little more range, and you can bring the heart forward just a little more. You can bring a blanket over the shins and then a block and rest your forehead. I never recommend putting a block right on the knees, never putting anything on the knees or putting pressure on the knees or on the right on the shins. Always bringing a blanket and putting something rigid on top if you want to support your forehead. You can also use a bolster and bring it across the shins, or nothing at all. If you don't mind that your head is coming forward and it feels okay for your neck, then just
Allow your breath to move through the body, creating softness
and opening. So stay in your forward fold. Eyes closed down. At whatever range feels good for you. We're not forcing. We're just allowing and being curious. A letting, kind of a sense of unfolding. Unfolding for each moment. Whatever comes up as you ride that inhale and exhale. Softening in the quadriceps, softening the hamstrings, noticing if you're grasping here around the knee joint and the quadriceps, consciously letting that go, staying with your deep breath, just one more minute here in the forward fold. This is a beautiful shape to re-energize and bring nourishment to your life nerve, your sciatic nerve, which is the longest, largest nerve in our body. And really important to keep that nerve healthy. Let's take a deep breath in and reach forward with your hands. Rise up, fill it up, and exhale. Bring your hands right by your hip joints and push down into the mat for Dandasana. And your heels will come away just slightly. It takes a little stress off out of the spine. And release down. Nice. So now we're going to use we won't use any props for this next shape. And this is one of my favorite shapes to create and work. So the side body fascial line. And really affects the gallbladder and the gallbladder, liver, and the spleen meridians in the body. And those are vital organs for filtering and cleansing the system. So bring your heels, your feet, to the bottom left corner of the mat. And then you'll bring your right hip to the right side of the mat. And you'll make your way down, your spine down to the mat. And you want to check to make sure both your sit bones are grounded on the mat. So sometimes I just shimmy side to side to make sure both my sit bones are on the mat. And then you're going to shimmy your shoulders all the way to the top left corner of the mat. You are creating the shape of a banana. And once you've created that shape, again, shimmy your hips side to side to make sure both sit bones are grounding. Arms are overhead. And then you'll cross your right ankle over the left. Cross your right arm over the left. Eyes close down and reconnect to your breath. Relax into
Stay deep with your inhale, long exhale. Seconds. This is also really good for your to lengthen your psoas muscle, which is considered a breathing muscle. It's connected to your diaphragm. So we want to do what we can to keep a healthy psoas muscle. We'll work the other side in just a few seconds. So the deeper inhalation helps to lengthen that muscle. The exhalation relaxes and softens. Let's take one last deep inhale. Exhale together in this shape. And now slowly begin to unwind and come back to a neutral position. And shimmy the hips side to side, just an easy shimmy side to side. And you're gonna make your way to the left side of the mat. So your left hip comes to the left side, your feet come to the bottom right corner. And again, shimmy to get both sit bones on the mat. You want to do your best to have your hips, each hip, grounded to the mat. And then you'll shimmy your shoulders to the top right corner. You want to feel a really nice stretch and opening on the left side body. Once you're there, just imagine that you are a banana. Cross the right ankle over the left. Left arm over the right. So typically what might happen is you could get some cramping in your right hip joint or your left ankle will not cross over because there's a lot of tension in the side body. That simply means that you need to come out of it just a little bit more. It doesn't have to be as extreme. So just bring your feet a little more to center so you're able to cross that left ankle over the right. Arms overhead, left wrist over the right. So here's what you don't want to see, this left hip coming all the way up. Just do your best to ground both sit bones to the mat. And eyes are closed down, reconnecting to your deep breath. We'll be here for 2 minutes. Just relax into the breath. Relax into what is. Relaxing into whatever comes up for you. So just noticing what you notice in this shape. allowing the soft tissue around the hip joint, the fascia. We're asking it to open, expand, release adhesion around the hip joint. Create space so that we can be more agile in our movement, in our play. Deepest breath, long exhale. Let's take a deep inhale together, long exhale, inhale, slowly begin to unwind and come back to center, shimmy side to side, draw the knees to chest, hug and squeeze. You're going to roll to your left side and slowly make your way up to a seated position. Please take your bolster or any pillow that you have, but a bolster is ideal for a long pillow. If you don't have a bolster, you can bring a blanket and fold it up long ways like this and bring it here to the center of your mat. But for our purposes here, I'm going to use the bolster and we're just setting up for the next the shape following the one we're about to do right now. So you'll take a blanket and bring it to the base of the bolster, and that's for your sacrum. I like to make sure there's no ridges or bumps in the blanket because that can be distracting and take you away from focus on the breath and where you're wanting to open in your body. So make sure there's no bumps or ridges in your blanket. So before we go into this shape, let's bring the soles of the feet together. You can walk the heels can be as far away from the groin as your body wants them. And that the further away, the less stress or tension, the closer they are to your groin, the more tension. So you decide how much tension you want in your body. Just a little cramps, things might come up like that. So your body, depending on where you are that day, you just don't know what's gonna happen. So you really wanna modify for whatever comes up for your body. So if you're feeling a little more stress, or maybe a certain shape is causing more tension or cramping, or you're not able to access your deep breath, then modification is what your body needs that moment, that day. So it's really important to honor yourself. And it's the deepest form of self-care, self-love. So find your spot for your body in Baddha Konasana. Lift out of your heart and relax your shoulders back. Softening your face, eyes closed down. And let's all connect to the breathing body. Deep inhale, long exhale. Create space for your life force to flow through you. I'm just clearing out those energetic channels, those pranic channels for the life force to move as it's intended to do. Deep breath. Let's take one last deep inhale in the shoe. Long exhale. Release your legs out long. And pulse. Side to side. And now for a last shape for this practice, let's bring the base of the spine to the bolster, the soles of the feet together. You can bring a block to each side of your knees. So we're going to take Supta Baddha Konasana, reclined butterfly. And bring another block over. Just let me grab it. It's really helpful to have support under your knees. Personally, I prefer to have blankets. Today, I'm gonna demonstrate with blocks. So we're first going to relax your spine back, bring the soles of the feet together, and depending on your range, so your knees could be up here, here, and you may not even need blocks, so if you feel you have a nice opening in the hip joints, it may feel good to you to just have gravity be working on opening the adductors, the inner thighs. Relax the shoulders and let them drape around the bolster or the blanket. The palms are up to the sky. And then just allow your eyes to close down. If you feel you need blocks under your knees, you can bring them in a few different directions. So this is one height, this is one height, and this one height. But most likely, we'll be using this height or this height. I like to position them where the flat edge is on my leg and not the sharp, rigid edge, because gravity will begin to, you'll have a sense, this might create a distraction for you. So just make sure it's comfortable as your legs are resting on the block. And then let the arms drape down. We want the sit bones on the mat. So it's the base of the spine, that the lumbar that you're feeling up against the bolster.
This is a beautiful heart opening shape. Relax into it. So let the eyes close down and reconnect to your breath. We want to keep the breath deep. Often we naturally fall into our what is sometimes called the default breath or natural rhythm of breath when we're laying down. So stay with your diaphragmatic breathing as you're resting back on a bolster or blanket. Eyes stay closed. Breathe. We're just beginning to allow the body to distribute the energy that we've been working with through this practice. So, just bringing the awareness to the full sensation of your body in these next few moments as you're resting back in Supta Baddha Konasana. Notice whatever it is you notice that comes up. We'll be here for another minute. Deep in the breath. So you might now bring your awareness to your heart center as this is a heart opening shape. And imagining in your mind's eye that your heart is filling up with life force, that pranic life force that's radiating out. With each breath, the light becomes brighter. The frequency stronger. Breathe into that miracle of you. Pure joy that's in your core being, in your heart space. Breathe into it, releasing any energetic resonance that is not serving you in this moment, maybe in the form of anxiety, fear. Release it. Breathe into the joy. Breathe into the radiance. Let go what no longer serves you. What is not working for you in this moment? Release it on your exhale. On your next deep inhale, draw the knees together. You're going to roll to your left side, slowly come up slightly and release your prop away.
And you're going to make your way down to a final resting Shavasana. So Shavasana, also called corpse pose. I like to bring a blanket under my knees. It really helps with the spine. So you can bring the hands to the backs of the shins, slowly coming down.
Releasing the legs long. Roll the shoulders in on the back, so that really lifts and creates space in the heart. Let the toes fall away from each other, palms to the sky. Let your eyes close down.
Here is where you come back to your natural rhythm of breath. The breath that we connected with at the beginning of the practice. Allow your body to relax and receive. And I'm going to offer a sounding, a healing with the crystal bowl as we breathe our way through Shavasana. So just relaxing your skin. Relaxing the spine. Softening your face. Relaxing your tongue. Let your eyes rest. Relax the jaw. The neck and shoulders relax. The arms and legs relax, allowing the whole body to surrender. Letting go of your grip, letting go of control. Allowing what is to be. Soft in the breath. Relaxed in your mind. Meditative. Calm. arms overhead. Stretch up.
Stretch
your luminous light. Draw knees to chest, hug and squeeze. When you feel ready, roll to the right side and take a couple breaths here on your right side before coming up seated. When you feel ready, come simple seated with eyes closed, hands to heart center. Let's all take a deep inhale together as one. Long exhale. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. May all sentient beings be free from suffering. In deep peace, gratitude and